From studs to duds, from Hall of Famers to busts, every NBA draft has its story, and some classes produce better players than others. There have been 74 drafts in NBA history, and in this video, we'll go over the top 5 draft classes ever. 1970. If you Google which NBA draft class has produced the most Hall of Famers, the answer will be the 1970 NBA draft, and that's why it deserves a spot on our list. Although some other drafts could have easily been mentioned here, such as the 1985 class with 5 Hall of Famers in Karl Malone, Patrick Ewing, Chris Mullin, Joe Dumars, and Arvydas Sabonis. Or even some newer drafts deserve an honorable mention, such as the 2011 draft class with Jimmy Butler, Kawhi, Kyrie, Isaiah Thomas, Klay, and Kemba. Or 2009 with Steph, Harden, Blake Griffin, and DeRozan. But because players in the newer drafts have room to improve their stock and potential Hall of Fame status, we'll give them space to do so and give some deserved respect to the old-timers. And there is plenty of respect to show for the 1970 class, which produced 8 Hall of Fame players. Bob Lanier was the first pick, and he turned into an 8-time All-Star who finished his career averaging 20-10, one of only 16 players in history with those numbers. His number 16 jersey is retired by both Pistons and the Bucks, which makes him one of the rare players who have jerseys retired with different franchises. The second pick was Rudy Tomjanovich, a 5-time All-Star as a player and 2-time champion as a coach with the Houston Rockets. Pistol Pete Maravich was the third pick and one of the best scorers and ball handlers the NBA has ever seen, and one of the most attractive players to watch in the 70s. His number is retired by 3 franchises, and with 24.2 points per game, he is still a top 20 scorer ever. The fourth pick was Dave Cowens, a Celtics legend who averaged 17.6 points and 13.6 rebounds, along with 8 All-Star selections, 2 championships, and NBA MVP in 1973. The 18th and 19th pick produced another 2 Hall of Famers in Calvin Murphy, a great Rocket shooting guard, and Nate Tiny Archibald, the only player who led the NBA in both assists and points in a season. Charlie Scott was picked in the 7th round and became 5-time ABA and NBA All-Star. And finally, there was Dan Issel, picked 122nd overall, who scored over 27,000 points in both ABA and NBA. Along with those 8 Hall of Famers, 4 other players made at least 1 All-Star team. So we can safely say this was one of the deepest draft classes ever. 1987. While the 1987 draft didn't have as many Hall of Famers, those who did make it to the Naismith Memorial were among the best players ever to do it. David Robinson was the first pick, and even though he came to the league 2 years after the draft, he quickly showed that the Spurs made the right choice. Apart from 10 All-Star selections and 2 NBA titles, Robinson had won all the individual awards possible, from blocking, rebounding, and scoring titles to Rookie of the Year, MVP, and Defensive Player of the Year. Scottie Pippen was the 5th pick, and one of the biggest draft steals ever, who Jerry Krause snatched from the Supersonics, along with drafting another All-Star and 4-time champion, Horace Grant. Reggie Miller, the future all-time leader in 3-pointers made, was selected with the 11th pick. To round out the Hall of Famers, Lithuanian legend Šarūnas Marčiulionis was selected deep in the 6th round. 87 draft class produced All-Stars in Mark Jackson, one of only 5 players with 10,000 assists, Suns legend Kevin Johnson, and the late Reggie Lewis, who passed away in the prime of his career. Several notable players like Muggsy Bogues, Kenny Smith, and Reggie Williams were also in this draft class. 2003. Most NBA drafts include some of the biggest busts, even the ones loaded with talent. In 2003, that bust was Darko Milicic, a talented but highly unprofessional big man from Serbia. He was supposed to have a career path on the trail of Dirk Nowitzki or Pau Gasol, but he wasn't physically and emotionally ready for the big stage at the time, and he'd spent his off time partying instead of training. In the 96 games he played as a Piston, he only scored 152 points and averaged 1.6 points a game. Despite such a dud with the 2nd pick, the 2003 class is one of the best in history because the rest of the first 5 picks are a lock for the Hall of Fame. LeBron James is on most people's Mount Rushmore. D-Wade is the 3rd best player ever at his position. Carmelo Anthony is one of the best scorers the NBA has ever seen. And Chris Bosh is a 10-time All-Star who helped redefine the center position on his way to winning 2 championships with the Heat. Apart from being extremely loaded up top, this draft had 5 other players who have made at least 1 All-Star team. Chris Kaman, David West, Josh Howard, Mo Williams, and Kyle Korver. There were also plenty of rotational players and starters who stayed in the league for a long time, like Boris Diaw, Jose Calderon, Kendrick Perkins, Leandro Barbosa, Zaza Pachulia, James Jones, Kirk Heinrich, Luke Walton, and several others. 1996. 1996 doesn't seem so long ago, but it was still a much simpler time when only one out of every eight people had a cell phone and when almost nobody was using the internet every day. In terms of the NBA draft, that was still a time where there were no mixtapes of high school phenoms that made them look like the next Michael Jordan, which allowed some of the best players in history to get drafted much lower than they should have been. Of course, we're talking about Kobe Bryant, who famously took his talents to the NBA from Lower Merion High School, where he was selected 13th overall in the upcoming draft. Other than Kobe, this draft yielded three other Hall of Famers, two of which were league MVPs, and the other surpassed Reggie Miller as the all-time leader in threes made. Of course, those are Allen Iverson, who was selected first overall, Ray Allen, who went fifth, and the Canadian underdog Steve Nash, who won two MVPs and became one of the best point guards ever. Apart from these four stellar Hall of Famers, there were four guys who got selected to at least one All-NBA team: Stephon Marbury, Peja Stojakovic, Jermaine O'Neal, and Ben Wallace. Even though Big Ben went undrafted, he still made his debut in 96 like the rest of this group. All-stars Sharif Abdul-Rahim, Antoine Walker, Zydrunas Ilgauskas were also a part of this staff class, as well as some other quality players like Marcus Camby, Kerry Kittles, and Derek Fisher. In total, the class of 96 gave three different league MVPs, all-time leader in threes, one of the best defensive centers ever, and a total of 11 All-Stars with a combined 68 All-Star appearances. 1984. 1984 was one of the biggest years in the entire history of the NBA. David Stern became the fourth NBA commissioner and would remain in that position for 30 years. He has changed the NBA in many ways, improved basketball as a game, developed and expanded the NBA brand, and made it more global. Of course, at the beginning of his reign, no one could have guessed in which direction the whole league would go. But just 6 months into his term, something happened that would greatly help Stern's plans. There was a new class of players in the upcoming draft that is still considered the best of all time. The 1984 draft featured the biggest star in the history of the sport, Mr. Air himself, and a player who many considers to be the GOAT. But Michael Jordan was only selected third overall, as the Portland Trailblazers picked Sam Bowie, which was the biggest mistake in NBA draft history. Hakeem Olajuwon was selected first overall, and nobody considers his choice over Jordan a mistake. And that is a tell of how good Hakeem was as a player. Charles Barkley of Auburn University was chosen as the fifth pick, and John Stockton, a playmaker from Gonzaga, got drafted 16th by Utah Jazz. Those four Hall of Famers were all top three, if not the best players at their position, and just among them, they have 47 All-Star appearances, 44 All-NBA selections, 7 MVPs, and multiple other individual and team awards. The famed 84 draft also brought Sam Perkins, Otis Thorpe, Kevin Willis, Alvin Robertson, and some other notable players to the league. To make the draft even more special, the New Jersey Nets picked Brazilian legend Oscar Schmidt, who many consider the greatest player to never play in the NBA, as well as Carl Lewis, who was chosen by the Bulls with the 208th pick in the 10th round, but would keep on winning medals in track and field.